Hello and welcome back. Today I want to introduce a new book to you, a new book in our study. It's called Communion with God. It's by a man named John Owen. And this book, as it goes under many titles, you may find it out in the publishing world. But Owen, at least as he introduces the book, he calls it Of Communion with God the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. Now, the main text that Owen uses to sort of explain how he came up with this work and what he's up to in this work is he looks at 1 John 1:3. In 1 John 1:3, the last words of that verse says, "Our fellowship is with the Father and with His Son, Jesus Christ." So in that text, our fellowship is with Father and Son, Jesus Christ. There seems to be a distinguishing in that verse of our fellowship with Father and with the Son. And Owen then, in his own work, says, well, that seems to be a legitimate thing to think about. It seems to be legitimate to think we have fellowship with the Father, we have fellowship with the Son. Of course, there's a triune God. There's Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. That's the doctrine of the Trinity, one God in three persons. And so his book has three sections to it. Part one, fellowship with the Father. Part two, fellowship with the Son. Part three, fellowship with the Holy Spirit. And so he's just going to look at the verses in the Bible that talk about our fellowship with the Father, talk about our fellowship with the Son, talk about our fellowship with the Holy Spirit. And so that's what he's up to in this work, and we are just beginning here with the first section. We won't look at it all, but we're beginning to look at that fellowship that we have with God the Father. Now, as Owen understands it, as he reads the scriptures, we had fellowship, humankind had fellowship with God in the garden, and we lost it then in the fall. So Adam and Eve had wonderful fellowship with God, and then a division was created between God and men in the sin, in the first original sin, and then there's now division between God, a holy God, and sinful men. And so the only hope then of us ever regaining fellowship with God, and this is key, is through Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ came, he dies, he rises again, and through Jesus Christ we have fellowship. We can now again have fellowship with the triune God, but only because of Jesus Christ. So the gospel of Jesus Christ is central to this. This book is a book for Christians, those who believe in Jesus Christ and are at peace with God through Jesus Christ, and they, because of Christ, can have fellowship with God. Now we next come to think about, now what does it mean to have communion? What does it mean to have a communion with God? And so we could use many words to describe it, a fellowship, as it says in 1 John 1:3, or a communion, a close companionship, maybe we might even think. And Owen explains communion then in this way. Our communion then with God consisteth in His communication of Himself unto us, with our returnal unto Him of that which He requireth and accepteth, flowing from that union which in Christ Jesus we have with Him. So the big idea, there's three main points to that phrase. I'm just going to kind of unpack it a little bit. One is that there's God, and that God communicates Himself to us. And so we'll get into this later about the ways that God communicates Himself. I mean, let me just give us a couple easy ones. God reveals His glory to us. God reveals His love for us. So we have God who is in a relationship with us, and He's showing us just how great He is. He's showing us just how much He loves us, right? That's the first point. The second point is that we respond to that appropriately. So what do we do when we see a glorious God? Well, we worship Him. We're amazed by Him. We respond appropriately. So we're in a relationship in which God shows His glory to us. We respond with worship. Or we might say God shows His love for us, and we respond by loving Him right back. Right? And so we respond appropriately to the revelation that God makes of Himself. We're in this fellowship, this communion with Him. And so, and then the third part is the emphasis that we made earlier, that this is only possible because we have union with Jesus Christ. If we are saved, if we're united to the Savior by faith, then we can be in this relationship, this fellowship, this communion in which God reveals Himself, and we respond appropriately to this great God. So that's the big idea behind communion. It's a fellowship. It's a joy-giving fellowship where we get to know God and we respond to this great God with whom we are honored to have fellowship with. And one of the things that Owen wants to say is, look, this communion with God will only be perfect in heaven. We should just have right expectations about how good our communion with God will be right now. And it's going to be perfect in heaven. It's going to be imperfect here on earth. The book then is not about how great it's going to be in heaven. It is focusing on that imperfect fellowship, yet grand. It's wonderful. It's joy-giving, the fellowship that we have with God here on earth. And he writes then of our earthly communion. He says it may have such a taste of his sweetness and excellencies therein as to be stirred up to a further longing after the fullness of his salvation and the eternal fruition of him in glory. Now, let me try to unpack that statement a little bit. The effects then of our communion with God should be tasting that the Lord is good, right? We ought not to say, well, God has revealed himself to me and I actually wasn't that impressed. No. It shouldn't work like that. He reveals himself to us in such a way that we have a taste for how great he is. We are excited by what he reveals about himself. It should have that sort of an effect on us so that we long to know him even more, to have an even closer walk with him. So it would have the effect on us that we're like, that is great, and I would like to think about him more, and I would like to worship him even in a deeper way. I'd like to know him even closer, in a closer way than I do right now. So it affects us with a great longing for greater communion right now. And at the same time, it will also make us long to be in heaven. Look, I can know him in a significant and a joy-giving way here on earth, but honestly, I can't wait to get to heaven because then my communion with him will be even greater. Here, John Owen wants us to think that communion with God is a wonderful, joy-giving thing and the kind of thing that once we experience it, we want more of it. And I hope that we are helped to long for a greater communion with God through our study of this book.